Hey, what's up guys? I hope you already updated your Figma application. If not, then do it right now because Figma has launched a lot of new features with the recent config. And today we're going to look at how to use the new auto layout features. So without any further ado, let's jump into Figma. Well, before that, make sure you already subscribe to the channel, hit that bell icon next to it, because if you're not doing that, then you're going to miss a lot of exciting updates. With all our future uploads. So yep, let's jump into Figma. Here I am in Figma and you would be seeing these updates here. You can see all these new features which Figma has launched. Figma has launched a draw feature where you can switch to the drawing mode and you can pick up your drawing tablet and you know, you can use the brush to create the drawings in Figma. You can use the pencil or the pen tool as it is usually, and there are lots of other brushes. You can choose any colors, you can choose a different set of brushes which Figma has here. You know, this is super cool, but today's session is more on the auto layout, not on the Figma's other features. But yeah, because auto layout is my favorite and I use it almost every day because it gives you a lot of freedom and a lot of ease in creating any complex layouts. But there was a massive miss in Figma's auto layout, which was the grid, because grid is something which we need in any CSS framework to create the responsive designs, and Figma has launched auto layout with the grids. So here we are in Figma. Today we're going to create a simple card with a new auto layout. So I'll switch back to the design mode, and now you can see we have design, we have draw, and we have dev mode. So I'm in the design mode and I'll start with a simple frame, let's say 300 by 300 or 350 or something, which is fine for you, and maybe 400 for the height. And you can see new nodes which Figma has. The top new features from Figma's draw properties panel are available in the Figma design too. Okay, got it. So no worries. Now you can see there is this massive change in the auto layout panel. You can see this is freeform, which is without any auto layout constraints. Then we have normal, you know, your vertical auto layout, and then your horizontal auto layout. And then the last thing is the grid auto layout. So what exactly we do in the grid? In the grid, we can define, you know, what exactly the grid size we want for the auto layout. So here we will be defining, let's say, a 3x4 columns grid. So three columns. Okay, sorry, 3x4, yeah, three columns and four rows, and it is completely depending on, you know, how do you want to design your layouts. I feel Figma should also have other features like hug content in the grid as well, but practically it doesn't make any sense. But it has ease for the designers to, you know, automatically adjust the height of your parent container, but no worries, we can manually do it. So to create a card, I'll just simply adjust the corner radius, okay, and I'll start with the title, card title, and to give it a nice size, let's give probably 34 pixels. And now you can see Figma has, let me zoom in a little bit, and I hope you are able to see all these small grids here. So I'll zoom in a little bit, and you can see my card title is automatically adjusted with a fill and hug content for the inner section and fill for this this small title block. But earlier when you use fill, it used to take the entire available space here. But now you can see with the fill, you can change the fill with the number of columns only. So now it has 2x1, and you can still utilize the other space or the other column for any other type of content. So as being a card, let's make it a full, you know, 3x1. And now you'd be seeing, okay, my first column is already utilized with the title, but there's still 50% or almost 60% of the space of the column is remaining. So what we have to do in these cases, we can manually change the height and width of the columns and the rows. Now here I'll select all these columns just by clicking these blue dots. If you notice these blue dots, so whenever you hover on any row or column, you can notice these dots on the left side and on the top, and you just have to click on these to select the entire row or the entire column. So I'll select the entire row and I'll change the height so that matches with my title. Now I would be adding a simple image. To add an image, I'll simply draw a rectangle here. And the rectangle, again, I would be using it for all the three columns and two rows. So I have a full-fledged image here. And I'll give it, again, 8 pixels for the corner radius. You can change the fill. All those things are as it is. Let's make the title as well a little bit aligned with our theme. And now let's have the last part is my text content. So again, I'll be using the column grids. I don't know why I'm typing because Figma has launched nice AI features as well to give us the content. I will select the text layer. I'll go to the actions and I'll click on the replace content. If you cannot find it, then just start typing replace content. It would be there. And in the replace content, you can just tell it, okay, give me some realistic content for Figma auto layout tutorial, and let it give us the content. Okay, I'll just clip it. And to clip content, I hope you already know, you just have to go to the properties of the text and then click on this truncate text. It automatically truncate your text in the available height, and I'll make it a 2-column height of this frame. So now you'd be seeing, okay, where are the spacings between the columns or the grids and between the auto layout frame. So again, I'll select the frame, and you can adjust the spacings of the parent frame still same way as we already had here. So I'll use 24 by 24 pixels here. And you can adjust the spacing between rows and columns here using these gap properties. So for columns and rows, I'll again use 24 by 24. So that way I have equal space all around the card. Now, if you want, you can change the height and width of the column, but this looks good to me. And you can see, when you select this and when you hover, you can find the gaps between the rows and columns even if your content is filled. So in this case, you can notice these highlighted lines where you can imagine where are the grids if you cannot see them properly in the field color. But yeah. Now let's add a button at the bottom, and I guess we need more height here. And now you can see my content has automatically adjusted because these two are still with the auto height, and it is automatically taking the available height of the content. And as I need one more row here, so what I can do, I can simply select back the parent frame, and in the grid, I'll just click here and I'll click on the, fifth row. So it has added a fifth row for me very quick, and you don't need to do all other hassles. It is pretty straightforward. I'll simply draw a rectangle just to represent a button. And let's change the height of this column. Okay. We can be more precise. Let's have 64 for the rectangle. And same way, select this. Okay. Now we have 64 pixels for this column, and you'd be seeing why I have this button just the two columns, because I want to showcase the use of the grid. So now if you have any other icon or a secondary button, you can fill in the remaining columns. And that's how, you know, you have created a nice Figma card with the grid layout that is suitable for any CSS framework. So when you design or develop the same thing, I don't know, we would be needing that, because Figma has also launched Figma sites where you can copy your Figma design as it is and paste in the Figma sites, not slides, in the Figma sites, and you can create and launch your websites just with the Figma design as it is. You can customize the breakpoints, you can add the breakpoints, and based on your breakpoints and the designs, Figma creates a responsive live site without writing a single line of code. It still has the feature to customize the code, so that is going to be an awesome update, and there is completely going to be game changer for the UI UX designers, because now designers also can start with the development, or the they can expand their horizons with not only design UI UX, but with the development features as well. So I hope, guys, you are already enjoying the new updates of the Figma. And if you want to learn more about auto layout, we already have a dedicated tutorial, a masterclass on the auto layout. You can find the link in the description as well as in the cards here popping on the screen. And yeah, that's it. Till the next video, keep watching, keep learning, keep designing.